it's Lola. This is my fourth video. I just wanted to show you what I'm doing. I've been taking out the brown braids. This is the last one that's in, and replacing them with some nice black ones. They're actually color 2B on its expressions hair. It's Connect Cologne hair. And I've only got like three more to do. But I just thought I'd show you how I do one cornrow if I can easily. But I'm really being very lazy. I'm just kind of using the parts that I've already done and kind of taking them out, keeping the parts in, putting a bit of leave-in conditioner and kind of soften up my hair. Then I'm going to braid it. So I'm going to show you how I start it, how I carry on adding in the hair, and hopefully how I finish it as well. Here's the first bit. I've just kind of made a tiny first initial part. It's part of the whole cornrow. And I've got the hair, which is 2B expressions hair, cut to the length that I've typed up. And I just drape it over. And the tricky bit is getting your hands in a comfortable position, especially since this is the left side of my head. Draping the extension hair around your initial parted hair and then grasping it, twisting, and then braiding. So pulling the furthest out into the middle and picking up some of the hair further along as you go. And that's just the whole trick of cornrows. MsBrice's video is really good for showing how to do cornrows. And it's just the same trick with a bit of extension hair. And then I'm going to add another bit of extension hair to keep it thick. So, another thinner bit of extension hair than the original one. And I just drape that over the two outer, one on the outer. I have my finger still holding the inner piece and the other one over, and I pull it tightly so that you don't see any big blubbing, and that way you just continue the braid of the cornrow. What I usually do is, once I keep going this way because it's usually pretty thick anyway, it's thick enough, and once I get to the end of the hair that is flat in the cornrow, I just carry on as if I was doing a single braid, a single plait. Just to loosen the hair there. It's really quite quick. I've already reached the end there, as you can see. And now I will just add another bit of hair to make sure that I have a thick enough strand and long enough for it to be the same length as the other hair strands that I have, since I've already braided a bit of it down. Hi, so this is me having braided it a bit further down, and I'm just going to carry on braiding like single braids. I keep putting a bit of gel on the extension hair as I braid down, so that as my hair ends it doesn't stick out. And of course making sure that I have equal parts, I just keep braiding down. And it's really quite quick and simple. Hi, so this is how it looks once I've finished it. I use the knotting technique at the end. So three knots, as shown in the single braids how-to video. MsBrice's video actually shows slower how to pick the cornrows, because it's easier when you're doing it on somebody's hair. And when you're doing it on your own head, it's kind of harder. You have to kind of do the hand-eye coordination, and you can't really see so much, so you have to just trust your hands and keep going. And it came out quite nicely. It's very neat. You can't see the bits where the extensions were added in along the vein of the hair, but it looks nice. And after this, I will dip this hair in boiling water. Each of them, I haven't dipped them yet, but that will make all these sticky out bits lie flat, so that then you don't need to trim them with scissors, and you can then put them to the back and cut them all to the same length so that it looks neat. and I'll show you what the finished look looks like. I hope you enjoy this. All right, now this is the final look. The ends are all dipped, and this is how it came out. All right, I hope you like it, and I hope it helps. All right, I'll see you later.